Yo guys, today we're going to be playing some Life is Strange, a game that I've heard about, I heard some good things about it, so I'm actually looking forward to playing this game. So, cut the intro short and get into it. Alright, well, let's start a new game, let's get straight into it. Let's see what this is about. Life is Strange is a story-based game that will features player choices. The consequences of all your in-game actions and decisions will impact the past, present, and future. Choose wisely. I like these sort of games, you
surreal.
They called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. Photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white.
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller?
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? And frankly, it's bullshit.
Really?
Shh. Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you in a moment of desperation. And any one of you could do that to me.
I'm looking, but
isn't that too easy?
Hold too left obvious. And drag towards a look.
What if Arbus chose to capture people with the height?
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Of their beauty or innocence. She had a brilliant eye.
I could look at my bag.
She could have taken another approach.
My little camera bag is battered, but still kicking.
I'm not a big fan of her work. I prefer Robert Frank.
Hey.
Me too, Victoria.
See this in my journal.
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
Maybe my favorite month, the best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change color, turning into tiny flames, but it's still too damn hot. I think it's good. And I can't bust out the big coats and sweaters for scary movies yet. Soon, Kate, let me borrow The October Country by Ray Bradbury. With Ethan Bradbury. I haven't read much by him, which caused Warren to almost revert my geek cred before I held up my copy of Battle Royale. But he nails the autumn atmosphere of small towns. The last time I wore a Halloween costume was with Chloe. I have pictures in one of my old albums. Find a real Halloween party to crash so I can experience some social mingling. It's That or Vortex Club Stroke Fest Swim Party. Or is that Backstroke Fest? You so punny, Matt. At least I'm trying to climb out of my cocoon. I shouldn't expect my life to completely change after a few weeks of Blackwell Academy, as my parents are telling me on a loop, I have all the time in the world. Probably a tumble to read. Much as I'm going to read all this, I'm going to...
He captured the essence of post-war beat America, and there was honesty about the economic conditions of the era, but a beauty in the struggle. You don't have beauty without a beat, which explains why Frank... I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie, a dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition, and Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits.
What do I say? You're asking me? I didn't know. I forgot. Who are you asking me? Why not?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
But she's the...
Very good, Victoria.
The school's
the Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype.
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century. But I like it old school.
Or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Cool.
Victoria doesn't waste a second kissing ass. I should have known. She'll have better equipment than Blackwell.
That's not really it. Let's just go.
Is turning in a photo, so... You see the dilemma?
I know, Mr. Jefferson.
This might make a cool shot.
Let's take the film. What it's like to be consumed by your work. I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event, and I want to represent Blackwell Academy.
You have just by participating, by putting yourself out there in the world.
Hey, we don't need to speak to this guy.
This is just a bump on a bigger road. I don't want anybody to feel excluded from this process, but I also want everybody to...
Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool.
Know that this photographic world is not for everybody. I had my moment in the camera.
Hi, Kate.
Oh. Everybody should. Hi, Max.
I only want to share whatever gifts I have with the world.
You seem quiet today.
Just thinking too much.
Victoria has already won. Let's go with the cup of tea.
I hear that. Want to go grab a cup of tea and bitch about life?
Thanks, but not today. I have to go over homework.
No worries. Let's hang later.
Sure.
There's paper booze about.
Now I wish I wouldn't have read this. Purge.
Wow. What? Says that what? Is it a porn video? Wow. I mean, she seems like the sort of like Christian... parents strict on her. So. Beat this geezer.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Do I have to? I just don't think it's that big a deal.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't wait to watch some more documentaries.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to. I feel like you always
welcome to the real world.
Cute?
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture to the class. Because Max wants everybody to see how hip she is.
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant camera.
Imagine a world without you, American girls. I'd like to be part of the world around you.
Driving you could. Car nobody can see my meltdown, except for me.
And it looks. What's this?
Now, who would bother to write that crap? I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy? Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift.
Wait, no. Oh, wow. Come on. That. Blue butterfly.
When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself.
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? C- Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Oh, shit.
No!
Oh. Damn. Wait, what?
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl.
No, it is. You got
I
one of those visions. They're telling you that something bad's gonna happen.
Back here. Yes, he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us in. I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now,
shit!
Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Capture the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy, anybody? I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane, can I actually reverse time?
No, I reverse the time. I just why are this? Vision.
Because like of her images movie. Of hopeless.
Wait, when did this happen? Only reverse time. Okay, that's pretty cool.
I did
now,
it.
Can you give
I
me
actually
example
did
of
it.
A photographer who perfectly captured
I'm a human
the human condition
time
in
machine.
Black and white. Anybody?
Wait.
Bueller? Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria.
Reverse time.
Why Arbus?
Take that selfie.
Because
again.
Of her images of hopeless faces, you feel like totally.
When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
What kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic
ooh,
tradition.
Gee.
And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
of course,
this.
As you all know, the
it's
photo
real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation.
So I can go back in time.
Says that one wakes up in
selfie
bed.
Expression.
What if that girl isn't
this?
Dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography.
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max. Since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation.
No, I can actually, okay. Just go straight up after they turn the bathroom.
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not going to get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me
Louis
after class.
Was a French painter,
and I need time to save that girl.
Yeah, you got
a
rewind.
Process to give portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again
process,
and give him the right answer?
Fine detail and people.
There you go.
Now, Max, since you've kept.
Yep. There you go.
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely
gotcha,
popular.
Bitch.
Mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of everyone. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Everyone, right? Speed
yes,
whoop.
Victoria, you still have. I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry.
Gosh darn it.
I'd never let one of photographers.
I'm not avoiding, just.
Biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you.
Listen to the picture in the Imperial section.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, so maybe I shouldn't have done that? Looks amiga.
Yes, Victoria, you still...
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photographer...
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
Let's save my breath.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy.
Yo, Daniel.
You know I don't tease.
I hate that science class.
Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing?
Fire.
Come on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to do! I'm so...
I need a hammer to break it open.
Okay,
to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Holy shit! Oh, okay.
I need a hammer to break it open.
You have one in your hand. What are you doing, crazy lady?
Hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass,
hammer,
would they?
Hammer, please.
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Jeez. No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Let me see the photo.
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real.
Is you in the
I
safe?
Just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone and please turn off that alarm since that's your job.
I hate me or something. I do to you. I will speak to this guy.
You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You could always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
Well, if I can actually rewind, I might be able to find my answer, but... Because it seems like this Nathan guy is actually at the top. You know, if I report him and then he finds out that Nathan got reported, Nathan finds out he got reported by me, and then he's going to come after me and maybe mess up my future, then, the truth might lead to him doing more crazy stuff. This is a tough decision. Really is a tough decision. I feel like this guy, if I was to tell him what Nathan did, I feel like he wouldn't do anything. I don't know why. I'm gonna have the truth. Might as well.
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie.
Wait, no.
And do you
wait.
Think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
I want to see what happens if...
I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
just
class.
Just tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside with class. Please.
Hey, let's see if I can actually rewind. Can I rewind?
That no, he does not fire that at all.
To change the outcome.
I may have just flushed my scholarship down the toilet. Yes, I could rewind and actually tell him the truth.
Alright, let's...
You look a little stressed out.
I want to know what his reaction would be to me telling him.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around. In the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott. You sure?
Yes. He was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. She could have taken a picture without the flash. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished family. And one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom.
Oh, there you go.
So what happened next?
Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally. Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
That's it?
You're not gonna look into it.
After what I told you?
We'll continue this discussion later, in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Yeah.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything, since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now. Should I rewind and change my story?
No, I'm just gonna stick with the I was sick in the toilet stuff.
You look a little stressed out.
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
just
class.
Just tell me what you're hiding. You can trust.
I'm gonna skip this. I know already what happens. Let's just leave it at that and go up to my left button to the main campus. Cool. It's a shame that the guy is like with some prestigious family, Blackwell. Is anyone else? Like the guy would have been like, oh yeah. We're gonna do something about it.
Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened
Amber
to her.
Is missing. That's when a car with a tattoo on the cuff of a dragon and a star on the inside of my left wrist. Damn, okay. Hey, let's talk to Mrs. Grant. Hey there, Mrs. Grant.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Excuse me, Max. I know everybody loves being asked to sign a petition, but would you do Miss Grant a favor and hear me out?
Sure, yes.
Sure, I always have time for you. What's the petition?
David Madsen, our chief of security, wants to put surveillance cameras all around the campus. Halls, classrooms, gym, dorm rooms, etc. Blackwell Academy should be a high school, not a high security penitentiary.
I don't even know what she said. I don't know what she said. That's crazy.
That's crazy. I get why schools should be on high alert these days, but cameras in the dorm rooms...
It's a slippery slope, and it's up to you and your classmates to stand up here. Blackwell Academy has a noble heritage, from the Native Americans who founded this land to the pioneers who shared it in peace, not fear and violence.
I'm gonna try to cut this conversation short.
You know a lot about Blackwell for being the science teacher.
Science is history, Max. And I have a secret wish to teach local lore and legends. There's a lot of unique facts about this you might really enjoy discovering. Now, before I assign you homework with this lecture, will you please sign the petition to keep our campus from going back to 1984?
Signing for the cameras and You know what? Having the cameras in dorms might actually be a good thing. Something might happen in the future. I might be in that situation. I might be at the CCTV. Oh, wait. I'm not there anymore. I'm not going to sign.
Miss Grant, I totally respect your passion and knowledge, but some security cameras make me feel a little safer.
I'm not against security, Max. We should all be concerned when private space becomes public. Your generation has been tricked to think everything should be recorded.
It's gonna have consequences. Does it ever not say it's gonna have consequences? Okay, I'll go.
Better read Warren's text before he blows my phone up.
How long has it been? It's been a decent amount of time. Okay, well, I can't avoid reading this. What? Okay, wait, okay, what's going on? Okay, wow. Lulu, sorry, running late and saying day. I'll meet you in the lot, looking cool, you'll see. My camera will be ready, see you shortly, I hope so.
Okay, right. I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
Do that. Alright, guys. I'm going to stop it here. I'm waiting the video in. It's been about like 5 minutes or so. Pretty long. I'm enjoying this game so far. It's pretty interesting. I'm going to see where it goes. And, yeah. If you guys enjoyed the video, you know, just leave a like, subscribe, comment what you think. You know, and, I will see you guys. 15 kids in the backyard drinking wine.